God's attributes were manifested to his pride in his last days. We have popped the revelation by the last prophet's message. And we know who we are and what we're raised up for. Praise the Lord, the original
life. Deuteronomy chapter 19. Mose numa atosu etido.
Deuteronomy 19, verse 14. It's a very popular scripture. That is full of warning. Thou shalt not remove thy neighbor's landmark, which they of old time have set in thy inheritance, which thou shalt inherit in the land that the Lord thy God giveth thee to possess it.
Amen.
And King Unanko Eshie A 34 Etra No Eja Papie A Wenya as I say, I will not put on a day of my own success of Harrison.
Proverbs chapter 22.
May you serve the tree of your love,
verse 28.
May you serve your love,
verse 22, 28. Remove not. The ancient landmark which thy fathers have set.
And drink Titishia. Ah, wait a minute.
Remove not negation. The ancient landmark which thy fathers have set.
And treat to this year. Ah, wait a moment.
Father, we thank you for your word. We have gathered here as eagles, ready, O Lord, to feed on the carcass.
Yes.
Your word says, when the carcass is, then the eagles will gather.
Yeah.
We give us flesh meat all the time. Anytime we meet, we eat flesh, and that flesh must be very fresh.
Yes.
Therefore, Lord Jesus, we have gathered here one more time as eagles from all over. Our purpose, the aim, the agenda is that you give us meat in due season.
Yes.
Father, today we ask you to come and take over this pulpit.
Yes.
Come and increase mightily so that I will decrease totally.
Yes.
Father, open the hearts of the congregation. Speak to their hearts, speak to my heart, that we live here as people who come to listen. Are people who listen and also become doers of the word. But your time is very close. It is clear that, Lord, the Gentile days are numbing.
Yes.
And there's no more time for us to waste. Therefore, this is an opportunity for us, O Lord, to revisit the past, to look at our characters, and move forward. Come and take over in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Topic is remove not the ancient landmark.
And pray a simple can you to be set and treat Titishia.
Look at how things are going in the world. And how Bible prophecies are being fulfilled. As our pastor told us yesterday that the Gentile days are almost at hand. Therefore, as bride, when we meet together like this, I reckon that it's a great opportunity for us to have a great introspection of ourselves. Go into our lives and then look into the future and then wait on the Lord for Him to help us to grow. It is as if in the message we have been feeding on milk for so many years. A child that feeds on milk from the womb is still 6 years feeding on the mother's breast milk. 20 years, when meet him, still feeding on the mother's breast milk, is so a child that is growing. That child creates problems for his father. That child brings problems home. When you go to the house and there's a particular child, every day they are shouting at him, it seems it means that the child hasn't grown. Because a grown-up child gets away from drinking breast milk to chewing meat.
That's
right. And then after chewing meat, that child moves to a stage where he begins to break bones. It means an adult is eating.
It is a good job. That is good. I said,
because it's only adults who can break bones. Home, bread, chicken. Home, and not chicken, the village ones. If you get the bones and your teeth is not like mine, they will remove your teeth. So an adult is the one that can take that bone and break it with the teeth.
It is only bones we chew.
Amen. We eat the flesh, and then we take the bones, you break smoke, I also break smoke, because we are all adults. But it's becoming as if when we meet, the milk is 99% and the bones is 1%. Because of that, preachers have no option than to recycle the same old message all the time. If you are not very careful, you might think they don't have a message. You might think they have nothing preaching. But our condition in the church does not allow us to move to meet and boast.
We are sorry, and she said, I saw it in the open. Am I a pine? Am I a team? You don't pay. And that I will be in the DMF. Oh, gently.
So brothers, you can deceptively remove the
landmass.
But there's one thing you cannot remove. This cornerstone has interesting features. It is a stone you see normal. So we can also decide to go and take greater.
So we go far greater.
Engrave the land. And engrave up on the stone. I don't know whether somebody is getting me. The greater we grade,
But the greater will break the top of the stone.
Greater will be able to eat the stone.
But this stone has some wires, has some linkages, which is deep into the earth. You can never remove it.
Sada boy, ewo asia pa asia pa. Ne wo yini wuti bitu.
We have an anchor that keeps the soul. It is grounded firm and deep. There are some children, there are some ministers, there are some brothers. Hey, you move it, they know how to go and look for their foundations. They know the word is standing. They know what? They know what? That's it. Okay, reference. Back to the original.
That's the catch when you don't know how.
Therefore, when Apostle Paul established
this cornerstone,
he referred back to the Old Testament. In Galatians chapter
1,
verse 8. And he said, but no, Galatians 1 verse 8, we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him or her be accursed. He adopted a strategy. And gradually he moved into the forest when the landmarks are with brothers around. Brothers were there. Sisters were there. And they were talking. Satan, you see, Satan will not go and use any other person. The same brothers, the same sisters. He incarnated some of them small. So as they are talking, their hands is on the ancient landmark.
Now
nowadays things are fine. This property, I like it though. You see where it is? Eh? It's looking nice.
Fine.
Your attention is not there. But so he's moving the ancient landmark. That God is moving. He's going. By the time they realize, the ancient landmark that was set here by the apostles has gotten to this place. The Roman system took over. During the Dark Ages, they took over the whole world and plunged this world into total darkness for almost 1,000 years. But glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. Who foreknew me and you before he created this earth. And before the foundation of the earth, your name was written in the book of life. He sent a prophet messenger. And then he came.
Bye-bye.
And when he came in 1933,
about 1933.
1933, as he was baptizing the Ohio River, the voice came and said, I'm John the Baptist. Well, as you forerun the first coming of Christ, This prophet is to foreground the second coming of Christ.
And blood, you know what is still.